Today on Inside Pierce County, we're going behind the scenes of Pierce County's salmon restoration work. Get in the creek.
Go, Paul. This is a beautiful site located right between Puyallup and Tacoma on Swan Creek. Why are we here today?
We are going to get into the water and collect some bugs and then look at the stream to see how well it is doing to support salmon.
Go, Paul. I don't see any salmon or any fish at all.
We are in what's called the fish window when the migrating salmon are not yet here and the juvenile salmon have left, and we only have about 6 weeks or so depending on the stream.
How many times do we do this to sample a stream like Swan Creek?
For sampling wise, for bugs, we do about once every 2 or 3 years. And then we also sample the water every month for about 50 different sites all over the county. So let's pick up a big rock and have a look at it. We would take this and scrub it in a way that the little bug is going into the cup.
And you want to get the whole surface so nothing sneaks by, right?
Yes. Often we tend to see caddisflies, mayflies, stoneflies. Salmon tend to eat them as larvae.
So this is real world stream science right here. We're living it.
Yes. What we are going to do is we are going to poke to scare the bugs that are in there so that they'll float straight into the cup. That we need to do for about 30 seconds.
Never splashed a net before. There's some stuff in there.
Yes. Yeah, you can see the caddisfly nest here.
I was expecting a lot of that. Small little bugs, not something that size. And stream temperature is also really important to salmon, isn't it?
Seeing caddisflies in the stream is a really good indicator for us to know that overall the stream temperature is good enough to support caddisfly.
Kevin, we're outside Ording on the upper Puyallup River, and it is beautiful, but why is this important for salmon?
So this particular project is important for salmon because it creates the habitat necessary to support both the treaty tribal rights associated with those fish and provides food for our native orcas in the Puget Sound.
Can you remind me about the life cycle of salmon?
Yeah, salmon start when they're born up in the upper watersheds. They actually move through the system, we call the rivers and creeks, out to the Puget Sound and then out to the ocean for several years. And then depending on the species of salmon, they return back to the actual place that they were born at. So we have an active restoration project just down the road. Let's go take a look. This is the Orville Kapalson project, and as you can see, this project involves putting in vertical piles and adding large wood structure for the purposes of creating habitat and doing floodplain restoration activities. Where we're standing right now, if you can see, the ground around us is much taller than we are. The actual river will be where we're standing at some point in the future to come.
I hear a lot about culverts and their harmful effect on fish. What's that about and what are we doing about it?
Yeah, so culverts are pipes that typically go under the road. They were designed years ago and they didn't necessarily account for fish. We will remove that existing culvert and replace it with a larger pipe or a concrete box culvert.
So we'll make a more natural channel so the fish can migrate up or downstream.
Yeah, we take into a factor the width of the stream and the slope of the stream. That really does impact salmon and how they actually migrate.
Thank you, Kevin. This has been amazing. I am so appreciative to our surface water management team who are making our environment better for people and salmon alike.